Hey everyone. Happy Casual Friday. Let's cash it up in here. This is Let's Play Popful Male Redux, and we're having a nice, breezy, casual Friday. Our Fridays are so casual, they might as well be Saturdays. That's our motto. This is where we talk to Venuncio and he dropped us through the pitfall trap there. I'm not sure where he went to, but, it's you.
Hi there. Fancy running into you again. Ah! Oh, Glug, you scared the mail right off me. I know you're a dwarf and everything, but can you show up a little less quickly next time? Yeah, sure thing. I was surprised to see you too. I just finished work and was heading back to my village. Well that's the way I'm going, so we can go together. Say, who's that behind you?
Ta-da! Yes, all your dreams have come true. It's Slicky!
You mean all my nightmares? This has got to be some kind of a curse!
Say, Maylee, you don't look so hot. Want a bite of my apple? I already took a bite, but hey, what's a little saliva between friends?
Ugh.
Thanks, but no thanks.
Well, you look kind of suppressed. Is there something wrong?
That's depressed, you nitwit. And nothing is wrong with me that a little distance couldn't fix.
Amen to that.
Oh, no! No! Glug, what's wrong?
Hey, look at that! They've got welcome fires burning! Are these dwarves great or what?
This place has obviously been looted and destroyed, Lunkhead. It's not here! They took it! Oh no! What's not here? Glug? Hello?
The Guardian! The Mythril Guardian! It's the protector of our sanctuary and the source of all our Mythril!
Glug, you don't mean the Holy Silver, do you?
Slick, what is he talking about? What is Mythril?
Sheesh! Were you raised in the jungle by a pack of gypsy iguanas? Everybody knows that Mythril is the metal that dwarves use to craft their magical devices. It's a sacred form of something called silver. Only dwarves can work with it, you know.
Well, you're a regular Mr. Know-it-all when it comes to the dwarves. I'm so impressed.
Well, I have spent quite a lot of time around the dwarves lately. And, just between you and me, I think they kind of like having someone around to look up to.
Look up. I get it.
They took all our Mithril. You must stop them.
Because they're short. Look up to.
Oh no! Raffy! Raffy! Hold on!
It had to be them. They wanted the Mithril, and now they've got it! Glug, who was it? Who did this?
It was the Rebel Army.
What? They're supposed to be against the monsters. Ooh, that Venuncio! Leave this one to me! I'll get your Mythril back, and I'll wring that blue-haired freak's neck in the process.
Male? I don't believe it! You're gonna work for free?
Well, I'm sure there's a reward of some kind in it.
Well, if I help, do I get a share of the reward?
Pinhead, if you help, there won't be any share to split.
No, this character we've never met before and thus don't care about is dead. My emotions, they have been manipulated. So yeah, pretty good casual Friday so far. No monsters or anything. But we do have a boss coming up that is the opposite of casual. It might be the worst boss we've encountered so far. And I hated the wood golem. But this boss, I don't know. It's a different situation because I have a lot more fruit for this boss than I had when I fought the wood golem. So it's going to be easier for me to just, brute force my way through it. But, it does a lot of damage to you when it hits you. Well, specifically when you touch it. So it is very easy to get overwhelmed and just outright die. I wish I didn't take that 9 points of damage. I might just go on ahead and use an orange now.
Well, hello again. Apparently, some people just don't know when to quit.
Venancio!
That's Lord Venancio to you, peasant.
Lord of Loserville, I'm going to put an end to your arrogant talk.
That sounds so scary. Do you have any idea what this guardian can do? The dwarves have made it strong with magic power. You don't stand a chance.
Hiding behind a piece of armor, coward? Get down here and let's settle this.
I'm not that dim-witted. This guardian is more powerful than you will ever understand. And I don't intend to come to your level. Your end is at hand, urchin. Witness the awesome power of Mythril!
Hey, what is this thing?
This, my dear, is a most powerful foe. It was crafted by dwarves using the awesome power of Mythril.
You already said
liar.
That.
If this thing is made of Mythril, how can it live?
Oh, believe me, it lives. So long, sucker.
Pretty clunky bit of dialogue there. Excuse me. So yeah, I switched to male not only for the dialogue, but also because she is the most effective person in this fight. Her speed and her weapon both make this a little bit easier than trying to fight it as... Well, a lot easier than trying to fight it as Gaul, and a little easier than trying to fight it as Tat. As you can see, we can't save. And I should have saved before I entered that door, but I forgot it was going to immediately launch me into a cutscene. So, let's just hope we don't die. Like I said, I have a lot of fruit, and if push comes to shove, I'm not afraid to use it. The main thing you have to watch out for is... Well, the main thing you have to watch out for is getting crushed, and those white projectiles that it shoots, they're easy to dodge, but they have a tendency to pop back up behind you. I'm going to go ahead and use a cherry here. So yeah, this fight not off to a great start. We've gotten a few good hits in on him. But as you can see, male speed is definitely an asset in this fight. If I had been anyone else there, then I would have gotten crushed for sure. And the boomerang, as you can see, has a good chance of hitting the same multiple times. You can hear it dealing damage twice. Those white things are a little unpredictable. The way they pop up after they go underground, I don't know, they tend to home in on you a little bit. But they're easy enough to dodge. Usually. Sometimes he's in a position where you just can't get away from him, and that's very unfortunate. Now this boss actually has two forms, and the second form, yep, should be coming up pretty soon. And this is all he does for the rest of the fight. And it's not that hard to dodge, but it is a little bit hard to get hits in on him while he's moving like that. Oh god. Man, I really want to go ahead and use that. Because like I said, this thing does a lot of damage when it touches you. You can get overwhelmed and... See? Oh man. Okay. I almost have him though. Ooh. Man, the tendency is just to want to try to get into a position to hit him. but you have to be careful. One more hit. Oh god. Why isn't it... Oh yeah, I forgot he actually has two halves. That's why I was able to get multiple hits in on him so easily. You have to kill both halves independently. But the other one's almost dead too. So yeah, as you can see, a little difficult to... There we go. Oh, that wasn't too bad. Had to use a lot of fruit, but you have to do what you have to do. Good casual Friday. I feel good about how that one went. That was close. Lord Venuncio. Where are you, Lord Venuncio? We have a score to settle, you and me. Old chum. We have, oh god. Oh yeah, there's, I thought there was going to be another cutscene right away, but we have a little bit to get through first. So that'll about do it for this edition of Popful Mail Redux. Hope you've all enjoyed this Friday edition, because this is absolutely going up on Friday. I don't care what the papers say. Tune in on Monday for yet another episode of Popful Mail. See you later.